Hi and welcome. This is preview of REDtoolbox version 3.1. For us, it's a major release and we implemented lots of features which will gonna help you in your daily work and which will speed up the processing, especially of multi-flight PPK projects.
So this is the user interface of REDtoolbox. We have three major workflows: the PPK and geotagging workflow, the shift EXIF coordinates workflow, where you can adjust the coordinates of your already RTK geotagged images to adapt to your local coordinate system, and a RINEX merge tool, where you can merge, for example, hourly base station file to a single file. This RINEX merge tool is also integrated in the PPK and geotagging workflow I'm going to show you right now. So let's start the PPK and geotagging workflow, and we're introducing an automatic project search. But let's first choose the device. We added some new devices which we support. I'd like to do with a PPK workflow, and we are also introducing geoid models. So you can upload or import your own geoid models into REDtoolbox, and they're going to be applied during the post-processing. For this preview, I've chosen a project which is subdivided into four flights with one base station. I keep the folder structure of DGI, and REDtoolbox will gonna search and merge all of them automatically. So searching is now in progress. You have to spread some breadcrumbs. So name the base station folder base station, for example, or base. And do not change DGI or Autel's drone folder structure. Keep them, they're already good. So the search is now finished and you see on the left-hand side that the images already become green. So we have 1,412 images, but the rover still red. The reason is because we have multiple trigger files. So we choose all of them and load them. We'd like to process all of them. For the rover file, precisely the same. I'm selecting the observation files, all four flights, and hit load. The bin files are recommended for Mavic 3 drones and for Phantom 4 and all others, well, you can use the ops file. Click load, and in the background, they will be merged to one single file. Rover becomes now green too, and we can go forward to the base station. The base station, the observation file is already loaded, but the navigation file, there are multiple available. But I'm choosing only the one from the base station and click load. For this base station, we have a manual coordinate available. So I'll do a copy paste and copy the latitude longitude coordinates into the REDtoolbox software. Same for altitude, but the altitude is measured on the ground. So what we implemented too is we're introducing offsets. So we have 1.8 meters pole height and an offset to the antenna face center of 0.241. Last thing is we can check the output settings as everything becomes green. I'd like to produce a PDF report and a text file, which can be integrated into any photogrammetry software. Writing EXIF is now extended to overwriting images, if you like, on your own risk. Hit run, and the processing and geotagging will start. Depending on the flight time, number of images, this now will take a while. You see, there are a couple of floats at the beginning, maybe during takeoff, but the fixed solution during the flight. After about 1 minute, the processing successfully finished, and we see that all of the images have been mapped with the coordinate. We can, in REDtoolbox, open a map. All images are green, so they are fixed, and we can view a table where we can check these two. So let's generate the output. and the files are written. After this step, we can open the folder and check. There is this raw text file output on the PDF report. Open the text file and you will see that all images have now coordinates with a high accuracy. The PDF report shows some statistics on the base station, on flight, and some nice maps.
So I hope you're gonna like the new version of the toolbox as much as we do. Enjoy. Bye-bye.